Hey, what's going on, APUSH peeps? We have video number 40 for you today. This one is on the Transcontinental Railroads, Westward Settlement, and Native Americans, all in the late 19th century. Before we begin, I got to give a shout out to Mrs. Wood's class in California. Mrs. Wood, your students think you are an awesome teacher that prepares them very well. So best of luck to you guys this year. You will do awesome. All right, so let's talk about reasons for westward migration during this time. Well, we have the building of transcontinental railroads that were often built by Irish in the east and Chinese in the west. Railroads were often given government subsidies in the form of free land or money to build them. And this really encouraged westward settlement because people are able to move out west more easily. Mineral resources is also another reason for westward migration. You have Comstock Lode in present-day Nevada, which led to a silver rush, and this will inspire people to look for minerals such as gold and silver in other areas out west. Government policies as well encouraged westward migration. The Homestead Act we talked a lot about gave 160 acres of land. The Pacific Railway Act gave subsidies to build a transcontinental railroad. And these created new communities and centers of commercial activity out west. So continuing with westward migration, many migrants moved to rural and boomtown areas of the west. Do me a favor and circle or highlight for me rural and boomtown areas. They hoped to achieve self-sufficiency out west, or being able to take care of themselves and their families. And this ties in with something known as the safety valve theory. This is a very important theory to know. It's the idea that one could always move west and make money during tough economic times. So no matter how bad things got on the East Coast, working in a factory, if you get laid off, this theory was that you could always move out west to make money. And this really inspired a lot of people to move out west. Economic opportunities was also another reason. Because of building of railroads, mining, farming, and even ranching, and we see Teddy Roosevelt in the 1880s, he moved out to the Dakotas and was a rancher. So what are the impacts of westward migration? Well, the bison population will decrease drastically because of all the hunting that's going on. There will be competition for land between whites, natives, and Mexican Americans. An example of this is the Sioux Wars, which began in 1866. This was a result of gold being discovered in South Dakota. The Battle of Little Bighorn, also known as Custer's Last Stand, was a victory for Native Americans in which Custer and all of his men were killed. A very important book you should be familiar with is A Century of Dishonor, written by Helen Hunt Jackson in 1881, and this chronicled a 100-year period of unfair treatment of Natives by the U.S. government. If you're following along with the enhanced video guide, we'll actually take a look at an excerpt from this book. So the U.S. government interaction with Natives as people are moving out west. The U.S. often violated treaties with Natives. In 1871, there was an act passed called the Indian Appropriation Act that ended tribal recognition as independent nations. And essentially what this did was it nullified previous treaties between Native Americans and the federal government. The U.S. would also use military force to resistance by Native Americans. You see this in the Battle of Wounded Knee in 1890, in which 300 Natives were killed, mostly women and children. And most Natives are going to be moved to reservations during this time, and they will experience a loss of sovereignty. So in light of competition for land, Natives are going to seek to preserve their autonomy or independence or way of life. So the U.S. will promote policies of assimilation, which means to basically Americanize Native Americans. This is seen through the Dawes Act of 1887, which sent Native children to boarding schools where they had to learn to speak English and even take on English names. Native families were given individual plots of land to farm, so you see a transition for Native Americans out west from hunting to farming. Natives also practiced the ghost dance as a way to preserve their autonomy, and this was a ceremony in which Natives envisioned the return of bison and the elimination of whites. And this really kind of scared the U.S. government, and many Americans sought to put an end to this ghost dance. So a quick recap, three reasons for westward expansion. What is the safety valve theory? What are some opportunities out west for Americans during this time? Conflicts between U.S. and Natives, be able to describe them. Helen Hunt Jackson and A Century of Dishonor, the oh-so-important book. And the Dawes Act and assimilation. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Look forward to seeing you back here for video number 41, Social Darwinism and Criticisms of Capitalism. Best of luck this year. Thanks for watching and have a good day.